today's class, I would like to explain about linear block course. So in the last class, already we discussed block coding. So how in block coding we will detect the error and how we will correct the error, and also the Hamming coding. So the main functionality of the data link layer is, so one of the function of the data link layer is, so it has to detect the error and it has to correct the error. So to do that, so it will take so many process or so many steps. So those are nothing but in that, mainly one of the type is block coding. So in the block coding, we divided the entire message into different blocks. So that means, so that each block may have k bits. So that k bits will called as data words, and so that we have to add some redundant bits to each block to make the length. So whenever we are adding extra bits to that specific code word, so we can call it as a redundant terms. Redundant terms, that means, so whenever we are adding, so for example, we are having a 3-bit code, so we are adding 2 or 3 bits to that code word. So those extra bits, those extra bits will be, it will be called as redundant bits. So by using that redundant bits, so at the receiver, so if my code may get any error during the transmission from transmitter to receiver, so at the receiver we will detect the error and correct the error by using the redundant bits. So that is nothing but block coding. And the Hamming distance by using the Hamming process, so we will also detect and correct the error. So Hamming distance, so we have to calculate the Hamming distance between two words. So based on the distance, so how many number of differences between corresponding bits, so based on the distance or how many bits present in the code word, so based on that bits we have to detect the error, and based and we also correct in the Hamming code. And another one is linear block course. So in this, almost all the block codes used today belong to a subset called linear block course. So if any type of so almost all block codes used today, so that will belong to a subset called linear block code. So a linear block code is a code in which the exclusive OR operation or addition modulo 2 operation of two valid code words creates another valid code word. So combining the block coding and the Hamming coding, so it is nothing but a linear block code. So in this linear block code is a code, so in which we have to perform the exclusive OR operation between the two code words. So whenever we are having 3 bits, for example, consider first bit as a 000, and another one is 111. So between those two code words, so we have to perform the exclusive OR operation, XOR operation. So the resultant is nothing but a linear block code of a two valid code words. So that will create another valid code. So whenever we perform, so it is like as a XS3 code. So already you studied XS3 codes and different codes in them, switching theory and logic theory subject. So here we have to perform the two bits, and the resultant is that is also a valid code word. So that valid code word will be present within a valid code word box. So then we will get a specific linear block code. So let us see if the two codes we defined in the given below a table, so that belongs to the class of linear block code. So in this, first one is The scheme in the below table is a linear block code because the result of XORing any code word with any other code word is a valid code word. For example, the XORing of the second and third code word creates the fourth one. And the scheme in the given below table is also a linear block code. So in this we can create all four code words by XORing two other code words, two other code words. Next, so in our first code, the numbers of ones in the non-zero code words are 2, 2, and 2. So the minimum Hamming distance is. So in this, the overall, in the minimum distance between the overall code word is 2. So the Hamming distance between the two code words is 2. That means in a code word, how many ones present in a specific code word. So that is nothing but Hamming distance. So by counting the ones, so that is the Hamming distance between one number to another number, that is dmin is equal to 2. So in the, if in our another table, the numbers of ones in the non-zero code words are 3, 3 and 4. So here the repeated, that means repeated term will be the minimum distance for a specific code word. That means here we have 3 is 2 times apart from the 4. So the Hamming distance between for this code is dmin is equal to 3. Dmin is equal to 3. So another one is a simple parity check code. So a simple parity check code is a single bit error detecting code. A simple error detecting code. So in which n is equal to k plus 1 with dmin is equal to 2. So whatever we consider the code words in a simple parity check code word. So here for the Hamming distance for any code word is 2. That means, so in this we have present two ones in any data word. So whenever we are considering any data word within the code word, we have dmin is equal to 2 with a condition of n is equal to k plus 1. And the simple parity check code can detect any odd number of errors. So it can also detect any odd number of errors. So that for the parity check code, so if the k is equal to 4, if k is equal to 4, so 4 plus 1 is equal to n is equal to 5, and the resultant code is equal to n is equal to 5. So at that 5 code word, that means 4 1, you know, so in data terms 8 4 2 1. So whenever we consider 0 1 0 1 is the equivalent for 5, so that will check the code word corresponding 5 numbers code word will be checked whether it will be received perfect 5 or any error will be occurred in during the transmission. So next one, so we have to some example for by using the encoder and decoder for simple parity check code. So here, so in any code word, so we have to detect or correct by using the encoding and decoding process. So here also we have the data word and the generator. So but here we have the parity bit. So in this code word we have a parity, we are adding a parity bit to correct and check the error while transmitting or receiving the code in this format. So in this modulo, so the encoder uses a generator, so that takes a copy of 4 bit data word, so and it generates a parity bit R0. So in whenever you hear whatever you are seeing the diagram, so here we are having the sender part and the receiver part. That means sender has to send some information, say the 4 bit data or 8 bit data, whatever it may be. So here we have the data word, that means so in this encoding process we have the data word, that is A32A0, and we have the generator in between the data word to code word. So here from the generator, so at the input of the generator we give code word to the generator, and the output, so the same data word will be some part of the code word. That means, so A3 and A2, A1 and A0 are the same bits, same code word as equal to data word. But here by using the generator, so the output of the generator will be generates some parity bit, so that will be given to the receiver. That means that by whatever we are sending the information from one device to another device, so that will along with the parity bit, that will reaches to the receiver, so that is nothing but in the decoder part also we have the code word and the checker and data word. So same, so the code word will receive the decoder and the checker checks all the bits, and by using the syndrome, so by that will check the parity bit, and finally if any error not in the code word, so that will be given to the decision logic, and if the, as it is same information or same message will be received at the receiver, so finally it will display the data word, whatever the transmitter transmitted the information from sender to the receiver, the data word that will be different. So if any error will be occurred, so that will be discarded. So that error correction and error detection and the correction will be done, and the decision logic, and finally it will be given to the data word. So here the calculation that it will be create the data word bits and parity bit create the 5-bit data word. So that is nothing but R0 is equal to A3, A2, A1, A0. So that is the modulo 2 performance. And the receiver receives a 5-bit word. The checker at the receiver does the same thing as the generator in the sender with one exception. The addition is done overall 5 bits. The result which is called the syndrome. So it's just one bit. The syndrome is zero when the number of ones in the received code word is even. Otherwise it is a one. So there is nothing but S0 is equal to B3, B2, B1, B0 plus Q0. So it is also modulo 2 operation. So this syndrome is passed to the decision logic analyzer. If the syndrome is zero, there is no detectable error in the received code. So if the syndrome present zero with along with the code word, so in this there will be no error within the code word. So the data portion of the received code word is accepted as the data word. If the syndrome is one, the data portion of the received code word is discarded. The data word is not created. So if the syndrome established or presents one with along with the code word, so that will be discarded. So a simple parity check code can detect any odd number of errors. So mainly the simple parity check error will be used for to detect the syndrome is detect to correct the errors, to detect and correct the errors. So and for this one example is we have some example, that is let us look at some transmission scenarios. Assume the sender sends the data word 1011. The code word created from this data word is 1011. So in data word we have 4 bits, but we are adding some extra one, that is 1021, which is sent to the receiver. We have to examine 5 cases. So first one is no error occurs. So the received code word is 1011. The syndrome is 0. So the data word is created. So 1011. So one single bit error changes A1. So So the received code word is 101001. So for this case, the syndrome is 1. So no data word is created. So if one single bit error changes or not, so the received code word is 10110. So the syndrome is 1. No data word is created. So if the syndrome is 0, so there will be accepted data word is corrected as the transmission code. So then the data word will be created. So if any one of the bit will be changes and the get syndrome is as a 1, so there will be no data will be created. No data will be created. And the fourth step is, so an error changes R0 and a second error changes A3. So the received code word is 00110. The received code word is 00110. The syndrome is 0. The data word 00011 is created at the receiver. So note that here the data word is wrongly created due to the syndrome value. And the fifth step is, so if the three bits A3, A2, A1 are changed by errors, so the received code word is 01011. The syndrome is 1. So the data word is not created. So this shows that the simple parity check and guaranteed to detect one single error can also find any odd number of errors. So here we have a two-dimensional parity check code. So here we have the column parties and the row parties. So here the column parties and the row parties. So parity check bits are calculated for each row for a two-dimensional parity check. So which is equivalent to a simple parity check bit. So parity check bits are also calculated for all columns. Then both are sent along with the data. At the receiving end, these are compared with parity bits calculated on the received data, So the entire bits will be sent to the receiver and it will be compared with the row and the column data bits, and finally you get the resultant data to be sent to receiver. So this is about two-dimensional parity check. So if one error affects what will happen, and two error affects what will happen, what is the resultant one. So that will also calculate in a two-dimensional parity check. So already we discussed the Hamming code, that is error correcting code. So the relation between M and N is in this code is equal to M = 2M - 1. So next one, cyclic codes. So in this cyclic codes are a special linear block code with one extra property. So in a cyclic code, if a code word is cyclically shifted, so its name itself indicating that cyclic. So the code word, whatever transmitted the data word from transmitter to receiver, so that code word is cyclically shifted or rotated, that is from last to first or first to last. So the resultant is another code word. For example, we having 0101. So whenever we are changed, that means last bit will come to the first position and second bit will go into third bit position. So we get 1010, same bit. So based on that, we get the sum resultant cyclic code. So in the cyclic redundancy code, so it will be used in mainly data communication, and we have some example of cyclic redundancy check. So that is we have the data word and we have the code word, and 001 and 005, the code word is 001. So by using cyclic redundancy, we structure of CRC is, so here we have the encoder and decoder at the sender and the receiver. So similarly, we have the data board and the generator and the code board. The data board, code board, and here also the data board, code board. So in the encoder, the data board has k bits. K bits, that means k is equal to 4. So in this example, k is equal to 4. So the data board is A3, A2, A1, A0. That is k is equal to 4 bits. So the code word has n bits. The code word has n bits. That means n here n is equal to 7 bits. So along with the redundant bits also, so we're having the 7 bits. That is, A is the original data is 4, and whatever we are adding, the extra bits will be 3 bits to create a code word in a cyclic redundancy check. So the size of the data word is by adding n is equal to 3, that is n minus k is equal to 3. So zeros to the right hand side of the word. So the n bit result is fed into the generator. So the generator uses a divisor of size n minus k plus 1. So it will be predefined and agreed for the generator. So the generator divides the augmented data word by the divisor modulo 2 type division, and the quotient of the division is discarded. The remainder is appended to the data word to create the code word. So finally, by this data and the code word, we will get resultant code word to send from transmitter to receiver. So from the transmitter to receiver, we have divisor and unreliable transmission. So in the decoder part also, a copy of all n bits is fed to the checker. So it is a repeat of the generator. So the remainder produced by the checker is a syndrome of n minus k bits. So it is fed to the decision logic analyzer. The analyzer has a simple function. So if the syndrome bits are all zeros, the 4 leftmost bits of the code word are accepted as the data word. So otherwise 4 bits are discarded. So if the error may occur, so we will discard all the bits. So if the syndrome is 0, we didn't get any errors and we can accept, and that will be the real. Apart from the redundant bits, so the data word will be displayed in the decoder at the receiver, at the receiver side. So here we have the division CRC encoder, that is the quotient and divided some process. So in this, the received code word is the sum of the sent code word and the error. So the receiver divides the received code word by divisor to get the syndrome. So finally, we can write this as a received code word is equal to C of x plus E of x by divisor. So CRC data and the polynomial, CRC division, equivalence of polynomial, and the capability. So the capability of the CRC is, so if the generator has more than one term and the quotient of x0 is 1, all single errors can be caught. So if a generator cannot divide x plus 1 bit, that is the t between 0 and n minus 1, then all isolated double errors can be detected. So a generator that contains a factor of x plus 1 can detect all odd numbered errors. So for length of error and the degree of the generator, so all burst errors with L less than or equal to R will be detected. So all burst errors with L is equal to R plus 1 will be detected with probability 1 minus 1 by 2 R minus 1. All burst errors with L is greater greater than R plus 1 will be detected with probability 1 minus R by 2 whole power R whole power R. So this is the probability of CRC and the representation. For the representation we have to, for the good CRC generator, a good polynomial generator needs to have the following characteristics. That means it should have at least two terms, and the coefficient of the term x power 0 should be 1. So it should not divide x power t plus 1 for t between 2 and n minus 1. So it should have the factor x plus 1, x plus 1. And the standard of polynomial, that is CRC 8, x power 8 plus x power 2 plus x power plus 1, which is for ATM adder, and the CRC 10 type, so x power 10, x power 9 plus x power 5 plus x power 4, x power 3 plus 1, which is ATM ALL, and CRC 16, so it is also HDLC. So for HDLC, we have to use CRC 16, that is hyperdata logical control, and the CRC 32, that is from 32 to standard X. One, which is used for local area network. So next one, check sum. So the last error detection method we discussed here is called the check sum. So it is last one and the priority one. So the check sum is easy to in the internet by several protocols, although not at the data link layer. However, briefly, we discuss it here to complete our discussion on error checking. So checksum is nothing but sum of the transmitting bits. So checksum is an error detecting technique that can be applied to a message of any length. So in the internet, the checksum technique is mostly used at the network and transport layer rather than the data link layer. So the data link layer control will perform the framing, flow and error control protocols, noiseless channel and noisy channel protocol, and the framing in the data link layer separates a message from one source to a destination by adding sender address and destination address. So the destination address defines where the packet is to go. The sender address helps to recipient acknowledge the receipt. So you can make any example. So here internet checksum, it is a 16-bit checksum. So at the sender side, the message is divided into 16-bit words. So the value of the checksum word is set to 0. So all the words including the checksum are added using 1's complement addition. The sum is complemented and becomes the checksum. So the checksum is sent with the data. So these are all steps will be performed at the sender side. So mainly the message will be divided into 16-bit words, and the value of checksum, that value is set to be 0. So all words, that means all bits included within the data, so the checksum are added using 1's complete addition, and the sum is complemented and becomes the checksum, and the checksum is sent with the data. So the data, whatever the data is to transmitted from the transmitter to receiver, so that will be transmitted along with the checksum value. And at the receiver side, so the message including the checksum is divided into 16-bit words. So all words are added using 1's complement addition. So the sum is complemented and becomes the new check sum. So if the value of check sum is 0, the message is accepted. Otherwise, it is rejected. So if the check sum value is 0, so there is no error and the message will be accepted. So if the check sum value changes to any value, so there will be error, and that will be detected and corrected by the decoder process. So if the error is not corrected, so it will, the entire data will be rejected at the receiver side. So again, we have to retransmit the data from transmitter to receiver. transmitter to receiver. So this is about different data detecting, that means data error detection and correction techniques. So thank you, one and all. DBS Talks.com in Twitter and